Mandisa says, good morning. And I'm saying, good morning. Thank you for being here. This is Angeline again. I want to continue with the overcomer, the being grateful, expressing gratitude for my life, or how we realize and reflect and find overcoming in our lives. Yes, yesterday I started from when I was born, all that. Now, I'm still in the body in Rapogi. Rapogi Girls, this was all for girls. There are challenges that I had to overcome. One was learning English. Two was getting myself friends. As a quiet child, confused, farm girl, didn't know how to begin it. Then I realized that I could use my mind. That means perform well in class, you'll get friends. Yeah. So all the time I could just sit and try and do the English, maths, my homework to complete, so that I'm not given the stroke of the cane the next day. If you don't finish your homework, you were to be caned, that's one. Then the other thing was, you be caned because you didn't perform well. 5 questions of maths, if you didn't get all the 5, you got 1 wrong, you caned 1 cane. 5 of them, 5 canes. 4. So if you get only 1 tick for the 5, you have 4 canes to count for. English, same. Kiswahili, all these things. So the teachers were giving us each and every day goal. Do your homework and pass for it. And English, it was comprehensive, and grammar, that was very hard. So I had to learn some of the vocabularies. So I had to work hard, and then I got friends. Those who could stay in class or finish their work to be in the class, and we started discussing maths, discussing English, discussing, so that we avoid that caning. Okay, then in 82 did my CPE, primary education certificate, passed, got my maths teacher on his bike. He brought my letter to my home, because I was the first student in the school. Those times, we were getting points out of 36, and I had gotten 35. They were proud. The school was proud, the board, everybody was proud. So the maths teacher brought that encouraged me. My calling letter was given, and that's what he brought. And it was for Kenya High. Kenya High is here in Nairobi. Remember, I'm there in the village. My parents could not manage to give me the requirements and the fees that was required for Kenya High. So a cousin who had been in Luwak, the daughter to my uncle, came to take me to Luwak, so that I get a good education, but a better, cheaper place. So I got help from relatives. My uncle's daughter came and took me to Luwak. They accepted me because of my points. My points was good. So that's how I began in Luwak Girls. From Luwak, of course, I realized in the primary that I could get friends because I was performing well. And remember, long time, the schools had streams. There is stream A, stream B, stream C, depending on how many, the population of the school. So in Luwak we had East and West. East and West, yeah. Two streams. So if you are in East, those who are high performance, there was West, those who needed more time. Not more time, even in primary Rapogi, we were in two groups, those who needed, yeah. You would be put, all schools were grading people where they needed more help. That would help others because, you know, there are those who are slow. They'll get it, but they need time. They need more contact hours. Yes. So there was prep time. You sit and do your work. I could use that. And that's how I developed the friends even in high school. I had a very good team where we could discuss maths, we could discuss history, all these things. And remember, we were choosing, but there were compulsory classes that we had to do. Thank God I had to drop history and Kiswahili. Those were the hardest subjects for me. So I picked up and it was compulsory to do English, maths, a science subject, and either geography or history. So I did geography, not history. But I realized that I needed discussion. I had to form a group. We were a group of 4 to 5 girls in all level, from form 1 to form 4, where we could break time for lunch, we could discuss or do our maths assignments. And then I realized maths was not so hard for me to do and understand and teach others. And then I could teach and we revise and I teach them, and that improved my skills. When you want to improve your skill, learn something, and then when you teach others, you learn more. You become an expert in it. So I could do that. Then the other thing was writing equations in chemistry. So others would help me, like there's a friend, she's a doctor now, Grace Akech, could help me with the biology and the English comprehension, these tough vocabularies that would come at me, how to learn them, but reading and doing my homework, the class homework, assignments, class assignments each day I had to finish, that made me go through. That was no question about it. You have to do all the assignments and finish. Remember, in primary we could be beaten for not completing. Just not completing your assignments, you'd be beaten. So finishing my assignments was one thing that I knew I had to do. And it brought me to myself. The primary routine of beating us for not completing assignment, it brought me back to myself. And I would realize, okay, in a day, I could have more than 3 assignments, because maths was daily, English was daily, then there was literature, which was there for maybe 2 days or so. We could do it 2 or 3 times in a week. And then there was other subjects. Either the science teacher could come and whatever. The science teachers could come once or twice a week or once a week in the class, but they give you assignments for next week. But remember, the maths, English, Kiswahili, and those others were daily. They could come in the class daily. So I had to complete. You don't do the assignments of other subjects when the teacher is in. So you had to look for your time to do the assignments. For months, we had that group of the two or three, four of us. So lunch break, immediately the lunch bell goes. If everybody is there, it's boarding in primary and the secondary. If everybody's running to line up for the lunch, we would remain behind for the next 10 minutes, figuring out what the maths assignment was. So if there were five questions, in that 10 minutes, if I could do the first question, that's good. Holding back and maybe drinking the water. Then we go fast, pick the food, eat fast, and the last 1 hour, because it was between 12 and 2, it was lunch break, people to go eat and come back. So that is your own time. No teacher is going to organize it. Only those who are doing their duties. So we go eat, the four of us, finish the food, wash your plate, put it there. You don't go to relax or gossip. We run back, then pick our books, be in class. If there are so many people in class, we go to the corridors. We had very nice corridors in Luwak where you could sit in the cemented tables and chairs and discuss. Do the maths. You say, oh, I've done number one, number two. Okay. Yeah, I'm stuck here. What is going on in this question? Then we do. Oh, then we decided as we reached form three, the four of us, we decided to structure our lunch discussion of maths. Yeah, there was no excuse of not going. So each lunch from Monday to Friday, we had a topic to discuss in the maths. But also, there is the morning preps where we finish our homeworks of all the subjects. But at games time, you stand, go change, get your tea, get you something to snack on, come back, do assignments, or we go to the field. We were the notorious people in high school. We are the first people to go to the field, jump a beat. When everybody is already in the field, we sneak back. The bookworms. We sneak back. We have a subject, maybe Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We put something. There is a day for biology, there is a day for chemistry, there is a day for physics, there is a day for that we discuss. And we had a timetable. Who is going to read on this Monday? It is chemistry. Is it Angeline's time to teach us about periodic table? Then next Monday is Grace's time to teach us about organic chemicals. Then the other Monday, it is chemistry, yes, but Betty Gichana was to teach us about inorganic chemicals. You know, we had that already put down. So when we reach that, we know that we have read, we have questions for this person about that, the inorganic chemicals or organic chemicals or equations. Yeah, you ask. You bring a question, but we have past papers to help us structure all this. And we could, after holidays, we could go and come back with papers from Yala High School, Salagongo, this one in Oyugis. There's a school in Oyugis called Oyugis High, no. there's a famous, those schools who could perform, there's Maseno High, there's, during our time, Sawagongo, Yala, Maseno, those were the schools where you get the scientists, the mathematicians, those who could do things. Rapogi High, you get, during holidays, you exchange past papers and bring. Past papers, national past papers were there. We formed a file for that. And we could try to answer these questions, because these are the questions we are going to face in Form 4. So when Form 4 arrived, starting from the first term, it was discussing the past papers. How would I answer this if it comes? How would I write the equation? So that is how I overcame the exams for primary, secondary, and then I went to advanced level, that is Form 4, Form 5 and Form 6. The same Luak Girls. Luak Girls, I was there for 6 years. So I did my exams in Form 6 in 1988. And there was the group of science class and the humanities, those who are going to be lawyers and all that. So I was in the science class. And still I had a group, though we were about only two, three or also. So discussion and group and facilitation is my thing. I get it. So I had to overcome by that. And right now I'm still a student. I overcome by discussion, and I have a group, a support group, and a class support group. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Overcoming is still more. I'm yet to talk about after Form 6, what next? Okay? Thank you so much. God bless. Remember to be honest. I'm honest. God bless.